In this diagram, we'll examine spermatogenesis, or the production of viable spermatozoa, the gamete cell in males. And this takes place in the seminiferous tubules, we'll see in a moment. Our figure here on the left, the main figure, is showing in its entirety spermatogenesis. So that is actually three main phases in sequence. It's multiple phases of mitosis, followed by meiosis, and then finally spermatogenesis. Now, for reference, we have our seminiferous tubule up here in the upper right, and this is where spermatogenesis is taking place. If we were to take a section of this and put a block around it, we're going to take that and essentially blow it up over here and examine just the cells that are involved in spermatogenesis. Now, you'll also see we have our blood testis barrier formed by the Sertoli cells in green. And during spermatogenesis, some of our cells are going to pass across that blood testis barrier. And the Sertoli cells are acting as nurse cells, aiding this spermatogenesis process. Now, on the outside here, we have the spermatogonia. These are the stem cells that are going to give rise to the cells that are undergoing the transition to become viable sperm. So we have here our non-differentiating spermatogonium. This is that stem cell on the outside of the blood testis barrier. It is going to undergo cell division and produce a differentiating spermatogonium and a non-differentiating spermatogonium. Okay, well, when this cell undergoes division, the cell is gone, right? We can't deplete this supply. And so one of those daughter cells has to basically just become and replace that original cell, so we have more stem cells to undergo this same division. The other one will pass into and across that blood testis barrier while undergoing spermatogenesis. And so that differentiating spermatogonium will enter the blood testis barrier. It's going to undergo multiple phases of mitosis, repeated cell divisions, diploid to diploid to diploid, right? This cell division, you're keeping the same number of copies of unique chromosomes. And so we see that division occurring here. And what we end up with is many, many, possibly hundreds of primary spermatocytes that are cytoplasmically linked. We've got little cytoplasmic bridges here, allowing coordination of this cohort of spermatocytes to undergo development. And the primary spermatocytes are the result of those phases of mitosis. That's going to enter meiosis, where we get two layers of division, two stages of cell division. These cells duplicate their DNA and then go from diploid to haploid. They're reducing their number of unique copies of chromosomes. And our secondary spermatocytes are going to divide again to produce the spermatids, still cytoplasmically linked and still haploid, but not yet functional spermatozoa. Those will enter spermatogenesis, and that is the process of differentiation, of changing the morphology, what the cell looks like and how it will function. And it does so by reducing its cytoplasm, growing this flagellum that's going to be used for motility. It's got its haploid DNA up in the head region here. It has mitochondria for powering that flagellar action. And the last thing it has is enzymes in that head region that are going to aid fertilization in the female reproductive tract. As you can see, those cytoplasmic connections have been lost, and we now have released our free spermatozoa, the sperm, into the lumen, as we can see up here in the upper right, to travel off into the rest of the male reproductive tract tubular structures.